Hello, and welcome to part 3 of our series on scientific writing. In the previous video, we looked at the OCR story structure, and in this video, we're going to go into more detail about how to actually write the opening. If you did the exercises from the previous video, you should now have this lovely little document with an introduction, a methods section, a results section, and a discussion section. And inside each section, you should have the answers to the questions you answered for each of the OCR elements. In this video and the upcoming videos, we're going to see how to actually turn those answers into a full introduction. Here are my answers to the questions from the opening. I find that thinking about these questions in this order is useful from the author's perspective, but from the reader's perspective, it makes more sense to reverse the order. So let's just flip these around. And now we can start turning the answers to these questions into standalone sentences. With these first three, I didn't have to do very much. I just copied them over. But depending on how you answered them, they might need to be rewritten to form standalone sentences. Here I will actually have to do that with the fourth sentence, which is now going to say, "We therefore want to find a way to model large multidimensional quantum networks." And now that I have something that resembles a paragraph, I'm going to copy it and replace the questions in my document with this paragraph. One thing to keep in mind is that at this stage, the writing doesn't have to be very good. In later videos, we will work on how to make your writing sound amazing. But at this stage, we just want to focus on getting the right stuff in roughly the right places. Another thing to keep in mind is that your opening needs to provide direction. In other words, it needs to tell the reader what the paper or thesis will be about. Here we can see that this paper is going to be about modeling large quantum networks. When writing the opening, there are two obvious ways to fail. One is misdirection, and the other one is no direction at all. So let's look at this modified version of the example. Let's focus on this sentence in red. It might actually be true and important, but putting it in the opening will give people the impression that this paper is about quantum key distribution. If it is important, but not what the paper is about, you can mention it in the right context later in the introduction. In his book on writing science, Joshua Schimel refers to this as mental whiplash. What about this version of the example? What is this paper actually about? You can't tell. The opening offers no direction as to where the story is going. Rather, it goes over basic textbook material about quantum information science and qubits. Using an opening that explains something most of the audience knows is common with inexperienced writers. If you're just starting out, then you're probably still learning the material and trying to assimilate it into what you know. It isn't yet ingrained knowledge, and you might have a hard time jumping over this material. There is nothing wrong with using your first draft to collect your thoughts by writing them down. But if you do this, remember that when the time comes to revise, you should figure out where the real story starts and delete the things that don't fit. Another important point to note is how wide should the opening be? Well, you should try to make it as wide as possible because you want it to be read and valued by a wide community. But you must also deliver on your promise. An opening wider than the resolution will have you over-promising and your readers will feel cheated. A resolution wider than the opening will have you under-promising. Your readers won't even see that you're telling a story that would interest them. A resolution as wide as the opening is right on target and your readers will be satisfied. Okay, so now it's your turn to do an exercise. I'd like you to take the document that you prepared in the exercises from the previous video, and then flesh out the answers to the questions, what is the larger problem you're addressing, and why are you addressing this problem, into a couple of paragraphs. You can do this by following the examples that I went through in this video. In doing so, you will write the opening paragraphs of your paper or essay. And remember that you should focus on structure. The writing does not need to be perfect. We will do more editing later. You should start off broad, then get narrower, like the top of this funnel. And be mindful of providing no direction or misdirection. You can pause this video as you work on this exercise. Try not to spend more than 10 minutes on it. Okay, let's summarize what we've learned in this video. You can write the opening to your paper or thesis simply by rewriting your question answers into standalone sentences. There are two main ways to fail the opening. One is misdirection, the other one is to provide no direction. Your writing doesn't need to be perfect at this stage. And your opening should be as wide as your resolution. In the next video, we're going to follow a similar process for fleshing out the funnel and the challenge. See you next time!